Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome out to Let's Play 999, 9 hours, 9 persons, 9 doors. With me, TapersCrazy, while last left off, we completed this room which has got a dead captain in here. I don't know, it's kind of a grisly sight, but we also started speaking to Clover, who has revealed that it might actually not be Snake who was blown to pieces in that shower room, so looks like we've got a bit of a hope going on, so let's continue on. Junpei looked confused. He hadn't thought she'd reacted that poorly. Clover began to pace across the room. 6 steps to the left. 6 steps to the right. Cha-chao, real smooth. Doo-doo-doo-doo. Another 6 to the left. And then she stopped.
Did Santa really tell you those things?
Her eyes were serious, but not angry. Yeah, he did. Did I say something wrong?
Oh, no, not at all. In fact, this could be really good news. I think.
You think?
Santa knew about the words and the clover. The only people who should know about that are other subjects.
Subjects?
There were people who were in the experiment 9 years ago with my brother and me.
Experiment?
But he's blind. And I was part of an Nevada test group. So neither of us would be able to recognize the faces of the people who were on this boat.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Time out. Junpei held up his hands. He took a deep breath and let it out. Let's just calm down for a second, okay? Start from the top. Don't start with the end and then jump to the middle. You gotta start at 1, then move to 2, and 3 and 4, and so on. Just don't get to 10 though, because I'll have to take my shoes and socks off to be able to count up past up to 20. If you don't tell me stuff in the right order, I'm never going to be able to figure it out. Clover nodded. Alright, let's start with this experiment. What happened on this boat 9 years ago?
Do you know about more genetic fields?
I do. People on this damn boat won't shut up about them. He did, and the realization sent chills down Junpei's spine.
Alright, how about this? Theory of a telepathic mechanism.
Junpei recounted what Lotus had told him earlier. Clover nodded.
Telepathy, huh? Well, that's not really it, but I suppose it's similar.
So they were testing telepathy on this ship?
Yeah, I guess so.
So, what exactly did they have you guys do?
The same thing that we're doing now. Exactly the same thing.
What?
The nonary game. 9 people were put on this boat, and 9 of us were put in the building in Nevada. And the game started.
What? So she's known about this game all along then? Junpei grabbed the sides of his head. Look, I'm sorry, but I don't get it. What do the nonary game and some telepathy experiment have to do with each other? Clover bit her lip. She blinked back, sudden tears. What happened to her in Nevada?
The ability to access a morphogenetic field is affected by a couple of things. The first is epiphany, and the other is danger.
The sudden realization of great truth.
I learned that from The Simpsons.
You know how sometimes when you're up against a really tough problem, and then the answer just kind of pops into your head? That's an epiphany. And what you learn from the epiphany can be transmitted with telepathy. When you add danger to that equation, then it gets easier to transmit that information over telepathy.
So you're saying the nonary game was supposed to introduce the element of danger?
Yeah, but it couldn't be just any old danger. It had to be life and death. And someone did actually die. A girl.
Junpei felt the sudden grip of despair on his heart. Something deep and distant and powerful squeezed, and for a moment he felt very, very empty and alone.
She was on the boat with my brother. I was in Nevada, so I never met her, but I did hear her name. Her name was,
The sound of a door opening was like a gunshot. Junpei spun around.
Oh, my apologies. Have I just cock-blocked again? I might as well call myself cock-block. Oh, my apologies. I seem to have disturbed you.
Ace.
You two must have strong stomachs. Can't imagine I could stay in this room for so long.
Ace glanced down at the floor. At the corpse covered in blood.
At any rate, Junpei, would you be so kind as to come and help me with something? I'm having lots of trouble and I could really use your assistance. Come on, it'll only take a moment.
Okie dokie. With that, he turned and walked back towards the communications office. Clover waited until he was out of sight, then spoke in a small, quiet voice.
I don't want Ace to hear us. We can talk about this later.
Huh?
Hey, wait!
Clover ignored him. From outside, Junpei could hear Ace calling.
Junpei, get a fucking moment! What are you doing in there? Hurry up!
Ugh.
Grumbling to himself, Junpei stormed off towards the communications office. Stomped off? I mean, what's he stomping for?
I'm Godzilla!
Okay, so now we're in here. What do you want from me? Let me just double check what items I've got. A music box.
A music box? Would you mind it first, Junpei? Sounds rather odd. What's this? The pins on the cylinder look rather strange. In fact, these don't look like pins at all. Looks to be some sort of board. We'll need to dismantle it to get a better look.
Which means I need a tool of some kind. Unless that means I can't do it right now. A music box. The pins on the cylinder look odd. We'll have to take it apart if you want to get a good look at it. Yeah, I'll need to combine it with some sort of tool, I presume. What's this? Excellent! That's the sort of thing I'm after, actually. Small screwdrivers. Can I combine these two? Alright, this screwdriver ought to make short work of this music box.
Okay. Looks to be a cylinder for a music box. There are a number of pins and some pieces of metal that look rather like fans attached to it.
Okay, wonder where we need to put that then. Ink. Okay. There's nothing in the drawer anymore.
There's nothing in the drawer?
Nuh-uh, there's air.
How old are you, 9?
You know, a few episodes ago, I was shouting at Ace for making bad jokes. There's nothing in the drawer anymore.
Say something funny.
Right, what about this stuff? It's an old telegraph machine. I'll be honest, I have no idea how it works. And these things. It's an old telegraph machine. Nothing suspicious here. Okay, what am I seeing over here? Ooh. The cable that comes out of this thing is connected to the desk. What does that mean?
A pair of headphones. I can't hear anything. Guess whatever they were connected to doesn't work anymore.
Okay.
It's a telegraph key. A machine for transmitting Morse code. I tried sending an SOS earlier, but I don't have added anything. She would never make it that easy.
So you think it's broken?
No, it works. Just not sure if it actually transmits anything outside of a ship.
Okay. Right. What do you think? Hey, Ace, look! It's a model of a steam train!
How on earth did you arrive at that conclusion?
It does kind of like a steam train. To be honest, I have no goddamn idea what that thing really is. It's probably some kind of radio transmitter.
Hey Ace, look! It's a monkey with glasses!
How on earth did you arrive at that conclusion?
It also kind of looks like someone who's been watching too much TV. To be honest, I have no goddamn idea what this thing really is. It's probably some kind of radio transmitter. Okay, right, is something in here?
Looks as though that drawer is the only thing that's locked.
I don't see a keyhole though.
An electric lock perhaps? Take a look at the left side of a drawer.
Yeah, there's some cables over there. That must mean that's what this thing's transmitting to then. Okay, hey, what is this? It's blank. There's nothing written on it. No. I get a feeling this is going to be like, you know, one of, you know that when you was kids and you used to go like to out in the woods and stuff with a piece of paper and a piece of what sort of, like a crayon or something, and like you rubbed the leaf on the paper and it made the leaf appear on the paper. I get a feeling that's going to be something like that. So let me just try combining it with this. No, okay. Wouldn't be a bad guess though. A white piece of paper. It's blank. A bottle of ink. It's filled with ink. Is it? I guess that's what a bottle of ink would be for. A chair. Nothing in the jar anymore. Okay. Okay. So that's everything around here then. What about this? Look, Hawk. That wasn't a joke. I know, man. Jumper, what are you doing? We've searched the wheelhouse from top to bottom. There's no reason to go back. In fact, don't you think it would be wise to investigate the captain's quarters? You've got to check both rooms, don't you? Yeah, you dragged me over here, you jerk. Okay, fine, I guess I'll go back. Alright, okay. I want to check these things. There's an R on this screen. It's one of those things that switches what's on the screen. See what happens if you flip one of these switches. Nothing. It's like it doesn't work anymore. That's it. Okay. What's this thing? I think this probably used to be a door. Nobody's going through it as long as this metal plate's here, though.
Whatever happened to our plates? The desk is in the way.
But yeah, we can move a desk. Huh. Okay, a lamp, nothing to see. A small table. Okay, well, I'm not really sure what else I need to do now, so I guess it's going to be one of those times where I'll cut back to you once I find the thing I need to be clicking on. There's a clock up here.
A clock mounted on the wall. My hands aren't moving. No surprise that the time is wrong, then, I suppose. And there's nothing on the back.
Huh.
A chair. It's a chair. If I sit in it, will you let me be chairman?
No.
Aww.
Oh, Ace, I love you. Don't ever change.
An early telecommunications device. Most likely used to transmit a radio signal of some sort. I experimented with it earlier, but to no avail. I imagine it's broken.
Huh. What if I do this? I guess I'll put the ink on the cylinder. And then roll this on the paper. Now I just got to roll the cylinder across a piece of paper. If I'm right, the ink should give me a Morse code chart. Okay. So do we try this on the Morse code machine? Alright, I've got the most code I'm supposed to enter. If I do this right, something will happen. I hope. Alright, let's give this a shot. Okay, what am I supposed to do here? Oh, right, press the button. One, two, three, four, five. Long one. Dot, dot, dot. Long one. If anyone's good in Morse code, what does this mean? I'd love to know. Perfect! Something happened. That's the last one, and... yes!
Excellent work, Junpei. Good job. Yeah, yes, look at me. I am amazing. You seem to have figured it out. You were knocked for a jar.
Okay, perfect. Get it. Let's open this sucker. This. A red file lay in the drawer. Junpei reached down and picked it up. The cover read, All Ice. All Ice. Alice. Did that mean... Junpei couldn't hold back. He had to know what was in that file. Each page was covered with strange characters. They looked like tiny drawings of birds, snakes, insects, horned animals, wings, and even kneeling humans. There were many pages in the file, and each was full of these strange symbols.
What the hell is this?
I'd assume it'd be Egyptian of some kind. He didn't realize he'd spoken out loud until Ace looked over at him.
Via hieroglyphs, a form of writing used in ancient Egypt.
Ancient Egypt?
That's right.
Can you read them?
Of course. I can't. What make you think I could?
What the hell? Junpei flipped through a few more pages. It wasn't just one or two pages that were covered in strange symbols. Every single page was covered in them. Trying to read them was pointless. Junpei wasn't going to waste any more time with them. He made to close the file, and something fell out. He bent down and picked it up. A key card. There was a symbol on it that reminded Junpei of the symbols of a Saturn and Mercury key cards. This one, however, had a dot in the center of a male symbol. Uranus. That's the Uranus. Oh, that's Ace.
Uranus. That's the Uranus symbol.
Junpei looked over to see Ace examining the card. In addition to the Uranus symbol, there were three words engraved on the card as well. On the lower right, it said, Bottom Deck Library. This must be a key to the library on the bottom deck.
Try to watch him.
The bottom deck. The library. Junpei remembered something he'd heard from Seven when they'd been in the chemical closet.
Only sleeps in a small chamber past the forest of knowledge, beneath an area of the gigantic.
Did beneath an navel mean the bottom deck? Did Forest of Knowledge mean the library? If it did, then was Alice in a room somewhere beyond the library?
What's wrong?
Junpei blinked. Only then did he notice Ace looking at him. Curiosity and concern written across his face in equal parts. There was no reason for Junpei to hide his thoughts. He began to explain his theory to Ace. Then he stopped. It wouldn't make any sense if Ace didn't know who Alice was supposed to be. So he told Ace everything June had told him. About the Egyptian priestess. About Ice Nine. And finally, about a woman who wouldn't melt, who had been recovered from the Titanic disaster. He told him about how she had been called All Ice, which had eventually turned into Alice. And how she had been purchased by an English millionaire who called himself Lord Gordain.
And how Gordain had hid Alice somewhere on the ship?
And you think that he hid her in a small room beyond the library on the bottom deck?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I guess so.
Has she?
Ace stared off into the distance, his hand slowly and absent-mindedly stroking his beard. After a few moments, his hand stopped. He turned slow to look at Junpei and his brows drew together.
Junpei, have you ever heard of the term CAS?
CAS?
It stands for Cells Alive System. It is an advanced technology for freezing and preserving organic matter.
God, the entire cast of this game will be so freaking good at a pub quiz.
Put simply, it is a technique which allows one to freeze things without the formation of ice crystals. Normally, if you freeze something fresh, water within its cells expands as it crystallizes, damaging the cell membrane. CAS, however, works differently. The object to be frozen is supercooled using magnetic fields and then frozen instantly and uniformly, giving ice crystals no time to form. It was originally developed for the preservation of food as an alternative to the normal freezing process. Now, however, there are rumors that it can be used for other things.
I would assume that would be along the lines of cryogenic freezing. What do you mean, other things?
Well, for obvious medical uses, but perhaps also space travel.
Space travel? Are you serious? And that is where we're going to end it, because I'm out of time for this video, so... next episode, we'll continue on this thought process and see where we end up. Anyway. Thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe here on YouTube. Vote, comment, follow if you're on VidMe. And I'll see you all in the next video.